Hello everyone, this is Dr. Carolyn Maria, working as an assistant professor in Loyola College of Education, Chennai. The title of the course is Knowledge and Curriculum, which comes under Course 8. This is Unit 3, Child-Centered Education. This is Part 2 video lecture, which is going to deal with the educational thoughts of John Dewey with special reference to discovery-based education and the educational thoughts of Plato, Martin Buber, Paulo Freire, with special reference to dialogue-based education. The learner will be able to gain knowledge about the educational thoughts of John Dewey, Plato, Martin Buber, Paulo Freire, with special reference to discovery-based and dialogue-based education. Let's learn about John Dewey. He was born in 1859 in USA. His father was a shopkeeper, so he was brought up in a rural environment. Usually, he participated in the discussion in his father's shop. Whoever the customer comes to the shop, he started having a dialogue with them. He did his PhD. He worked as a lecturer, professor of philosophy in Chicago University and University of Columbia, etc. And he visited many countries like Japan, China, Turkey, Russia, etc. Let's learn his educational implications under five side headings as aim of education, curriculum, method of teaching, role of teachers, freedom and discipline. According to John Dewey, the main aim of education is to develop an ability to understand and analyze the problem. As I told you already, during his childhood days, he was helping his father in his shop. So, he saw so many people coming to the shop, conversing with him, talking about some problem, and he was participating in the discussion. So, he said that the aim of education should be problem solving. So, the aim of education is to develop the skills for intelligent application of knowledge to solve the problem, and also to arouse the interest through planned experiences, and also to help the students in the adjustment to the changing needs and ideals of society. So, every student should be ready enough to adjust himself according to the change happens in the society. So, education should motivate a student to become a self-reliant person. According to him, there should not be any fixed curriculum. Activities and projects should be promoted, and those projects should lead to reconstruction of the experiences by giving various experience to the students, and we should have an integrated curriculum. With regard to the methods of teaching, he said that mind is just like a workshop. So, we are supposed to give a lot of activities to the mind in order to generate the mind, and the method of teaching should be stimulus response with in relation to stimulus and response. We should give a lot of stimulus to the mind to explore various thinking by which a student can solve the problem by learning his own experience, by which he can go for a discovery method of learning. So, project method and experiential learning, he has given much emphasis for. According to him, the role of teacher is very essential in the student's life. A teacher should be a guide, and teacher should be a sort of stimulus or a catalyst to make the students to think on their own, and observe and plan and encourage the students' activities. And teachers should promote various good environment, learning environment for the students to get good learning experience. And teachers should be professionally trained and an efficient person to discharge his or her duty very successfully. And teachers should have sympathy for the students. According to John Dewey, he said that three sorts of disciplines should be promoted. Number one is social discipline. He said that students should be given enough opportunities to cultivate the social attitudes, social habits and ideas by which they can create their own self-discipline, and that should be a free discipline. That should not be with any sort of boundary and all. And students should have a very good creative mind to have their own self-discipline. Let's learn now what is discovery in education according to John Dewey. He said that each student is unique. So, one pattern of education does not fit everybody. But we are having one pattern of education. One teacher, one period, one subject. She is teaching to so many students at a time. That is what we are following. But that should not be there according to the discovery education of John Dewey. He said that the student should be given enough exposure to explore, experiment, ask question and as well as find out answer with free mind. And students should be always given an active role in the class, and they should not be passively simply listening, and we are supposed to shift the content to the process for the students to go for a deep understanding, and by which they can accept their own failures and they can consider their failure as their stepping stones. And students can become very active knowledge builders, and they can create their own knowledge because they are given enough opportunities to discover their own interest and construct their own knowledge. And the zeal for learning should be there in the students forever. It should not be stopped only with the school education or college education, because the education, whatever is given to the students, should promote the natural curiosity, and the teachers as well should motivate the students to go and search for knowledge by which they can become very good inventors and innovators, and they can think out of the box. And education should aim for the mental development with social interaction by developing their critical thinking, divergent thinking, problem solving, and decision making skills. So, education should promote overall development in the students by discovering their own self by their own experiences. Let's focus on Plato now. Plato was born in a noble family. He was a philosopher. He was a very famous Greece philosopher, and he was the founder of the Academy of Athens, and that was considered to be the first institution for higher learning in the Western world. And he was preparing himself to enter into politics, but after seeing Socrates, he has abandoned his political career and he turned to become a philosopher. And he opened his own school in the outskirts of Athens, and that school was a very famous school, and it was called as Academy, and it is generally regarded as the first university in the Western history. He was a student of Socrates and he was a teacher of Aristotle. Now, Plato, Socrates, Aristotle, these three people are there. Who was the student of whom and who was the teacher of whom? Let's have a memory technique. SPA. You can have it in your memory as SPA. So start from Socrates. Socrates is the ultimate teacher. Then comes Plato. Then comes Aristotle. So Aristotle is the student of Plato. Plato was the student of Socrates. So SPA. You have it in your mind. SPA. You will never forget. So, Plato was both a writer as well as he was a teacher also. His writings were in the form of dialogues, because whenever he wanted to know anything, he imagined that Socrates, his own teacher, is talking to him. So, everything he would write as a dialogue format. So, the mere word dialogue came from a Greek origin, dia and logos. Dia means through, logos means word. So, dialogue means through word. So dialogue is the mutual sharing of thoughts and listening as well as even understanding. He said that it is a vehicle for our own soul searching, and it helps us to understand our own self as well as even the teachers as well as even the others. And it will increase our tolerance in order to know ourselves and introspect our own self and observe even the others. And the role of teacher, according to Plato, was just a facilitator. and teachers should help the students to create self-awareness and reflect on so many questions. He has promoted the skill of questioning in the students. The method of teaching should be only intellectual dialogue between the teacher and the student. So these are the ideas of Plateau with regard to dialogue-based education. Let's focus on Paulo Freire. He was born in September 19, 1921. He grew up in northeast Brazil, where his experience were deeply influenced by his life work. Actually, the world was having a lot of economic crisis at that time, and people were suffering with hunger and poverty. All these he was experiencing. So he lived in a poor family and along with the laborers, so that he gained a knowledge and understanding about the lives of other people who were below socioeconomic status. So he supported for the education of the oppressed in his later stages. So his pedagogy was, he mainly said that reading the word is not much important, rather reading the world is very important. In the sense, we are supposed to get ourselves involved in the development of critical consciousness with regard to understanding the problems of the people. Reading simple words in the textbook will not give you knowledge, rather reading the world by going to the people, conversing with them, having a dialogue with them and understanding their problem, that will enrich the knowledge of the student. And the formation of critical consciousness allows the people to question the nature and their historical and social situation also. So to read the world with the goal of acting the subject, that will create a sort of democratic society, so that when a person comes forward to understand another person, ultimately they will respect the other person and it will create a democratic society. He also said that there should be a very good dialogue between the teacher, students and the society. Dialogue not only between teacher and the student. Teacher and the student dialogue was according to Plateau. But Paulo Freire said that there should be a dialogue between teacher, student as well as the society, where the teachers also will learn, as well as even the society also will learn, as well as even the students also learn. So that will end up in the meaning making of everyone's life. Let's focus on Martin Buber now. He was born on 8th February 1878 at Austria, and his parents were separated when he was at the age of 3. So he had to go and live with his grandparents, and his grandparents has inculcated a value of reading books in him. So he thought that books are his own friends. So by which he had a lot of time to think and reflect on. So he has developed two sorts of concepts, two sorts of relationship. They are I and thou relationship and I and it relationship. So according to Martin Buber, he said that human existence may be defined by the way in which we engage a dialogue with each other, as well as with the world, as well as with God. So Plato said that dialogue should be between teacher and the student. Paulo Freire said the dialogue should be between teacher, student and the society. He is adding one more concept called God, that is thou. Thou is God. So there should be a dialogue, proper intellectual dialogue between yourself, that is oneself with God and oneself with human beings, other human beings. So one with creator, another dialogue with the creation. So Martin Buber, I and thou presents the philosophy. He said it is a personal dialogue between God and the self, that is God the creator and self-awareness. So that will increase the self-awareness in the students. As well as a student should go for a dialogue between I and it, that is dialogue between the self and the creation, by which the man can ask so many questions to the nature and the other people, by which he can gain knowledge. So the knowledge develops when questions are asked to God, world and even the others. So education should aim for promoting a very good intellectual dialogue between self, God and others. The key takeaways are, teacher should have sympathy for the children. Teacher should design innovative teaching learning strategies in order to sustain the students' attention. More reflective questions should be discussed in the class for the students to create a very good curiosity to construct their own knowledge. Some points for reflection. What is your view as a teacher in the following aspects? Discuss the present as well as the future. According to you, what should be the aim of education? At present as well as future, you are supposed to give a discussion or keep reflecting on curriculum, method of teaching, role of teacher, freedom and discipline. I have given some books for your further reading. Wish you all good luck, students. Thank you for listening.